to get R. Kelly on this record, I went to Chicago 8 times over 20 months. I went to 5 shows on his tour.
He's talking me down. I think, you know, because he's persistent, man, and relentless, you know, he kind of reminded me of myself when I was trying to get on.
Drums are set up. It's getting exciting. It'll get lively here in a bit.
Cassidy in the house.
The legends.
What's
here.
Up, buddy?
These are the drums in the 80s that I did 99% of the records on.
So give us a few of the records that you recorded with these.
Michael Jackson, Frank Sinatra.
When he says Michael Jackson, he's talking about
Thriller.
Just in case you didn't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, Wawa Watson has stepped in the building.
You here to annoy me. That's all.
You want to hear the next
one? You like annoying me.
You want to hear the next one?
And you the only motherfucker I let get away with it. Hey, Mark.
Yes.
Why are you acting so cool? I mean, you know your trickery?
Yeah.
But that 16 bar?
Yeah.
Be you.
You want more trickery?
Behind so many Luther Vandross records, but let's just hear this one.
You remember it?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today working on some guitar with this man, the legendary Ira Siegel.
Yep.
And you know, when I was working on track 7 with Greg, it was clear we wanted a guitar like this. When I put my favorite 25 songs of this era in a playlist in iTunes and said I want my album to sound like these songs and looked up all the musicians who played on these songs, I saw his name on about 24 of the 25. I was like, Michael Jackson's horns and Chaka Khan's and George Benson's and the Brothers Johnson. And I was like, this guy must not be bad. I wonder where he is.
Here I am.
What if in the breakdown you do a trombone solo?
It's a trombone solo?
Everything is in divine order, man. You know, to have all of the cats that worked on Michael Jackson and all these great artists, man, before me, you know, I felt like he opened up the musical path for me to get on and blend with them. And the spirit is ridiculous because of it.
Here we go. There's something special in my heart about this song.
It's kind of happy, you know. It's kind of a
yeah. It's got joy.
Yeah, it does.
It has joy.
I fell in love with the video concept as soon as Cassidy sent it to me. You know, because it's all about people. It's not about the artists. It's all about the people. Plus, we did it in my city. They shot down forever, baby.
It's 12 a.m. right now. We got the whole station locked down.
You know, I stalked a lot of people. I got behind a lot of people and like, yo, man, y'all gotta listen to this. Y'all gotta put me on. And because he's like that, is the reason why I'm here today. The song is blowing up and the song is hot.
I traveled to Chicago 8 times over 20 months. I went to 6 shows on his tour. I went to Barnes & Noble to his book signing, waited in line for 7 hours to get to the front. It took me 20 months to record the record, Make the World Go Round, and another 15 months to get him on his train to shoot this video.
That's what it takes, people. You gotta get more like Cassidy, you know what I'm saying? Y'all wanna get things done.
He made it, he's here, the eagle has landed,
yes,
3 years in the making. I'm about to cry, you don't even understand.